Welcome to our channel Life Insights. This time our question is, what is enlightenment? Is there a stage in our life called enlightenment? Or who is an enlightened being? Is there any reality in being enlightened? Let us explore and investigate. We have already stated that without exploration and investigation, we are not going to accept anything. We find that we have ignorance in our day-to-day life. We have lots of conflicts. These are all facts. We want to resolve all those conflicts. We want to go beyond ignorance. If someone is interested, he or she may be free from ignorance. That is very much certain. It happens in our practical life. Some are violent, some are not violent. Some are bad, some are good. We find these dualities in our day-to-day life. If somebody is interested to go beyond all these dualities, one can do so. So it all depends upon ourselves, what we are to do in our life. But certainly nobody likes ignorance. So to end our ignorance, we have to be very much aware about our day-to-day life. Enlightenment is that thing where ignorance is absent. Hence, enlightenment has a beginning and it has no end. Once a person is enlightened, he understands the reality of life. He is capable to face the realities of life. He has no conflicts in himself. He is not afraid of life or death. He faces life as it is. First of all, he observes the outside world. Then, with the same observation, he comes inside. He is very much interested in his inner reality. We are living under time. This is a fact. It indicates that there must be a stage where time does not exist. We have our own mind. There may be a state called no mind. These are all possibilities. We have to investigate ourselves into our own being to understand all these realities. Various masters have told that they have different experiences, like out-of-body experiences, samadhi, enlightenment, etc. To know about all these kind of things, we have to go inward. We have to investigate. Then only we can understand all these things. Various masters have told that enlightened person can face life as it is. He does not have conflicts in his life. He has gone beyond all dualities. That stage must be there. That state of mind must be there. Because our mind is always conditioned. So if I am interested in unconditioning our mind, then what I am to do? I am to observe my own mind. We are living under the influence of time. There may be a state where time does not exist. These are all possibilities. To encounter all these possibilities, we have to investigate. An enlightened master has told that an enlightened person behaves like a normal person. Two horns will not grow on his head. Just like an ordinary being, he is moving in this earth. He treats all the human beings as equal. He will not be in conflict with anybody. He is not identified with any particular place, or he is not identified with a particular race. He is not identified with any language. For him, the whole existence is one. As we have told, the reality is one. When this is understood, one may go very easily beyond conflicts and ignorance. Flowering of a human being is known as enlightenment. This we can glimpse in our own life. Some are very much violent, but we find some people are not violent. If we are able to face ourselves, then we can face anything in our life. The greatest question in our life is, how can I face myself? Because all the problems are created by the human beings. I myself is the reason for the conflicts. I myself is the reason for the ignorance. So if I am interested, I can end the ignorance and conflicts. That state is called as being enlightened. When intelligence awakens, we want more significance to our own life. Certainly, life has such an option. Now, it is entirely up to the spiritual seeker to go for that. Nobody is forcing us. It is our own choice. So life can be explored and can be found out. As we have told, life is the greatest miracle in front of us. One is to understand that. Then life offers all the blessings unto us. Once again, we will be coming up with another one video explaining another aspect of life.